So in this tutorial, I'm going to show how you can generate a wall and make it follow a sloping ground. And at the same time, I'm going to show you how you can change any bay to go to any height on that same wall. So it's kind of two tutorials in one. I go to Scaffold, and of course the first thing you always need to do is to go to the setup and specify the main height of your scaffold. So I'm just going to go to 7 meters. I'm going to specify deck every level, and in this case, just for this example, I'm going to have no side brackets or hop-up brackets. Click OK. Now I'm going to manually draw a line by clicking on the line command, and as per previous training sessions, you can use your background image to trace around a background image. So I'm going to draw the line, so just click on the first point, and if I drag along, you see how the system actually tells us the length of the line. So this is going to be approximately a 10 meter run scaffold. I don't have to have sloping ground, but for this example I'm going to put some sloping ground on. And to do this, it's a matter of putting slope tags on the actual line itself. So let's actually make it slope starting at zero. So we have a zero point there, and we can just manually click close to the end. Right click to repeat the last command, which is adding another tag, and this time we're going to go -5. Now remember, the height of the scaffold is 7 meters, which means that if we go -5 with the sloping ground, we're going to have a 12 meter high scaffold at the highest and lowest point. So I'm going to manually click towards the end there to get a -5 meters. So that's our sloping ground. To generate the scaffold according to that sloping ground, we can just click on Make New Wall, and notice that side brackets are switched off because we specified no side brackets for this drawing. And we then specify line polyline, and we want automatic slope. Select the actual width of the actual scaffold run. Let's stick to 1.2 meters. Click OK. And basically, it's a matter of now clicking on the actual line and then clicking on the sloping ground. And it's now attached this scaffold run to the actual sloping ground. And it's also followed that line. As usual, we can use our normal editing tools to make changes, add ladder towers, stair units. But what I'm going to do is edit this wall by clicking on the Edit Wall button on the toolbar. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to make a section of this scaffold go up even higher. So I'm going, or maybe just one bay. So I'll just click on that bay. And I'll say, okay, well, let's change that particular bay to go to, say, 14 meters. And that's the only change I want to make. So instead of applying it to the wall, not the whole wall, I just want to apply it just to the selection. So I'm just going to window around just that one bay. And now that's changed. So let's see what happens when we build 3D. Now, because I've made this bay higher, it's probably a good idea if I put some handrails on there. So let's do that. So let's click on the actual handrail option, and we have a handrail on the west, and we click on that handrail, and we put handrails on the east. Let's delete some of this bracing that we don't want. I'm just pressing the space bar to repeat the last command. and then build 3D on it. Right click to build the whole scaffold. And then I'm going to specify our 3D view. And we can see that as specified earlier, we have our height of 7 meters for the general run of scaffold. Our sloping ground starts at 0, so it's basically 0 to 7 for that very first bay. Our last bay, our lowest point is -5, so we go from -5 to 7 on that last bay. And then of course we have the edit wall that we did, which we change that separate bay to be 14 meters high. So there we have it. We have the sloping ground by adding slope tags, and then we use the edit wall on the toolbar to change any bay to any height we want. So we can actually, you know, scaffold the spire of a church or a gabled roof or vary any height anywhere we want. Thanks for watching this sContract design tutorial.